Now let us see the next problem, that is, so I have taken under the 2018 question paper, the 10th problem. Under the 10th we have A and B. The A is a social accounting problem, the B is environmental accounting problem. Let us see the problem. Eco Limited is a manufacturer of environmental friendly products. It has adopted GRI guidelines for maintaining its environmental responsibility. The following key information is extracted from its books and you are required to compute certain KPI as per GRI norms. So already I told KPIs means key performance indicator, as per GRI means the globally given the norms. Okay, so we have the items here, the turnover, energy used, quantity of materials consumed, quantity of recycled materials used, total water used, water recycled, hazardous waste generated, hazardous waste recycled or generated. So for all these items they have given the 2016 and 2017 year. Okay, now we have the only the four as the key performance indicator, because here we didn't heard the any of the word as the greenhouse gas emission. So that is going to be not calculated here, only the rest of will be calculated here. So these two can be used for the first one, next two for the second one, the next fifth and sixth can be used for the third calculation, and the last one will give you the hazardous recycled material. So now let us see one by one calculation. So here I already wrote the problem, so we can see all this now. Okay, the calculation of KPI as per the GRI norms, already I wrote the title. So the first one is energy used. So the formula is total energy used multiplied into 100 divided by turnover. So let us take the separate years 2016 and 2017. So what is the first one? Total energy used. So 52 and 65. The same I am going to take here, 52, 65. So the turnover is 250 and 280. 250 and 280 multiplied by 100. So how much percentage will get? So let us see. 52 multiplied into 100 divided by 250. So we got 20.8%. So next one, 65 multiplied into 100 divided by 280. So we got 23.21. So this is the percentage in case of the first one, that is energy used. Okay, next one, let us see the use of recycled material equals to recycled materials used divided by total materials used multiplied into 100. I have wrote in the short form, but you write in the full, that is materials. So again we have the different years, 2016 and 17. So let us see the quantity of materials used. Okay, that is recycled. First we are going to take, that is 90. The recycled materials 90 and 92 here you can see. So next one is materials consumed. So that is 450 and 480. 450 and 480. So multiplied by 100. So let us see. 90 into 100 divided by 450. So we got 20%. So next one, 92 into 100 divided by 480. So we got 19.16%. Okay, similarly we'll go for the use of recycled water, the third one. So the formula is total value of recycled water used multiplied by 100 divided by total water used. So what is the divider here? So it is total water used. So here the total water used. So the water recycled is 800. That is the first thing here, right? So that we are going to take the total volume of recycled water. So this first we are going to take, that is for the concerned year. So 800 and 1000. So the total water used is 3000 and 4500. So I am completing the formula. So let us see what it is giving the answer. So 800 into 100 divided by 3000 will give the 26.67%. Next one, 1000 into 100 divided by 4500, so will give the 22.22%. So this is about the third one. Let us see the last one, the fourth one. So that is the recycling of hazardous waste. So under this we have the amount of hazardous waste recycled. So that is, so here you can see the recycled amount is 45 and 65. Okay, don't see the other items. So it is quite messy. 45 and 65. So divided by the hazardous waste generated. So that is 125 and 130. 125 and 130 multiplied by 100. So how much percentage we are getting? Let us see. 45 into 100 divided by 125 will give the 36%. And next one, 65 multiplied by 100 divided by 130, so will give the 50%. So this ends the problem. So hope you understood all the calculation from energy used, use of recycled material, use of recycled water, and the last one, recycling of hazardous waste. So these are very simple problems. So by taking the formula, so we can easily calculate. No further calculation is needed to get these as the amount. So please keep awareness about this formula, and these are the very easiest problems in your entire subject.